Good evening from Hyderabad. My name is Manjulata Kalanidhi and I'm the moderator of the panel today. Welcome to our next webinar under the webinar series, COVID-19 Outbreak on the Frontline, curated by the Harvard T.H. Chan School of Public Health, India Research Center and Project Sanchar. To understand our host, here is a brief about them. The India Research Center is the first global center of the Harvard T.H. Chan School of Public Health. Established in 2015, the center has three strategic goals of research, teaching, and translation of evidence into policies and programs. The center provides a platform to facilitate faculty exchange and partnership between public health researchers and Harvard Chan faculty. The center is led by Professor K. Vishwanath, Lee Kum Kee, Professor of Health Communication at the Harvard T. Chan School of Public Health. Project Sanchar, or Science and News, Communicating Health and Initiative by Harvard IRC, is aimed at building the capacity of journalists to draw on the latest science and data for shaping public knowledge, attitudes, and policy on health. FACLI, as we are all familiar with, is a media and research organization that began with data journalism in 2014. FACLI works to transform the public information landscape by making data and information meaningful, to people. It is a well-known entity in the fact-checking space and partners with various entities to take fact-checking to various cross-sections of the population. This webinar is being co-hosted in collaboration with the U.S. Consul General in Hyderabad. Today, our discussion will focus on the role of media in shaping the public perception on COVID-19 and its vaccine rollout. Today's eminent panelists will discuss the current crisis on COVID-19, including strategies to mitigate the crisis and vaccination and the related vaccine hesitancy. The 60-minute webinar aims to improve the understanding of journalists and lay public in communicating science and health during public health emergencies and promote public understanding and actions to mitigate the crisis. This panel stems from the recognition that journalists play a critical role in disseminating accurate and actionable information and help viewers and readers cope. For opening this webinar, we have Consul General Joel Reisman with us. To give a brief introduction, Mr. Reisman assumed the post of U.S. Consul General in Hyderabad on August 20, 2019. Prior to this assignment in Hyderabad, Mr. Reisman served as Deputy Chief of Mission at the U.S. Embassy in Dhaka, Bangladesh. Before joining the State Department, Mr. Reisman served as an Assistant Staff Judge Advocate in the U.S. Air Force. Welcome, Mr. Joel Reisman. Over to you, sir.
Thank you very much, Manju. I appreciate it. And good evening to all. I want to thank, first of all, the Harvard T.H. Chan School of Public Health, India Research Center, FACLI, and Project Sanchar for organizing this important event and inviting me to speak. I want to thank you, this distinguished panel, some of whom I know well, like Dr. Sangeeta Reddy, for offering your expertise today, which far outweighs mine. And I'm pleased to be part of this important discussion about communicating vital public health messaging, particularly during this COVID-19 pandemic. Before I discuss U.S. efforts related to COVID-19 vaccines, I want to offer my condolences to all of those who have lost loved ones or fallen ill during these challenging times. The United States stands with India as we fight this pandemic together. Reflecting our solidarity with India, during the past 2 weeks, the United States has delivered 6 plane loads of supplies to India, and those efforts total $100 million in value and will provide urgent relief. The United States has also redirected its own order of AstraZeneca manufacturing supplies to India. And this action will allow India to make over 20 million doses of COVID-19 vaccine. In addition, U.S. state governments, private companies, NGOs, thousands of Americans from across our country have mobilized to deliver vital oxygen-related equipment and essential supplies to Indian hospitals to support frontline healthcare workers and the people of India most affected in this outbreak. Just as India sent assistance to the United States early in the pandemic, the United States is determined to help India in its time of need. Apart from our life-saving coordination with India to fight COVID-19 here, the United States is involved in a global effort to ensure worldwide access to the COVID-19 vaccine. From day one, President Biden has made stopping COVID-19 the top priority of his administration. Ensuring broad and equitable access to vaccines is an essential part of achieving that goal. To that end, the U.S. government made a $2 billion donation to the COVAX program, which will supply COVID vaccines to low and middle income countries. And the United States has pledged another $2 billion that we will provide as other countries fulfill their own pledges. Once India has recovered from the crisis, our countries will continue working together to expand global vaccinations, manufacturing, and delivery. The United States recognizes that as long as COVID is spreading and replicating anywhere, it poses a threat to people everywhere. So we're here tonight to discuss COVID and misinformation, which is really a critical nexus. The numbers vary by country, but in much of the world, a significant portion of the population still is not convinced they want to be vaccinated. The rollout of vaccines is a major challenge, but as they become more readily available, the fight against misinformation will only become more pressing. We should acknowledge the good news that we are getting more and more data on the benefits of vaccination. Two recent studies in the United States found that fully vaccinated healthcare workers on the front lines had extremely low infection rates, less than 0.2%, compared to unvaccinated healthcare workers. That's why events like this one are so critical to ending this public health crisis. Media organizations need the training and resources to engage in evidence-based communication to convey authoritative, accurate information in an engaging manner and to directly counter disinformation. The panelists here today all represent excellent resources when it comes to communicating about public health, especially on the COVID-19 vaccine. Thank you again for sharing your time and your expertise with us today. And I want to thank all of you in the audience for your interest in the vital work that you too can do to ensure we all have access to accurate and authoritative public health information. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Reisman. You really summed it up for us briefly yet very effectively. Thank you so much. To all our friends, Telugu journalist Evaraithe join ayaro andariki kuda
Harvard Zina, I got it. Okay.
On behalf of Harvard TH Chan School of Public Health, India Research Center, Patli, and Project Sanchar Tarupuna, ikkada join ayina Telugu mariyu English journalist andariki kuda swagatham palukutunnanu. Ee webinar lo COVID-19 vaccine lo reporting, COVID-19 vaccine la reporting, journalists emi telusukovali. Ante asalu reporting ela jarugutundi, manam inka elaga improve chesukovali, elanti tools use cheyali, జరుగుతున్న దుష్ప్రచారాన్ని మనం ఎలా ఎదుర్కోవాలి, ఒక సోషల్ మీడియాలో జరుగుతున్న ఫేక్ న్యూస్ కానీ అలాంటి వాటిని, ఇవన్నీ కూడా ఈరోజు మన మనకున్న ప్యానలిస్ట్ అందరూ కూడా చాలా ఎమినెంట్ ప్యానలిస్ట్ ఫ్రమ్ వేరియస్ డిపార్ట్మెంట్స్, వాళ్ళందరితో కూడా మనం సంభాషిద్దాం. ప్లీజ్ బి కైండ్లీ జాయిన్ ఇన్. థ్యాంక్ యూ డాక్టర్ రైఫ్, థ్యాంక్ యూ మిస్టర్ రైఫ్. హియర్ ఇస్ అ బ్రీఫ్ ఇంట్రొడక్షన్ ఆఫ్ అవర్ ప్యానలిస్ట్, ఆఫ్టర్ విచ్ వీ విల్ బి starting the panel session with Dr. Sangeeta Reddy. First, I will just introduce you to the panelists. Dr. G. Srinivas Rao, Director of Public Health and Family Welfare, Government of Telangana. Apparently, he's slightly tied up right now, and we are hoping he'll join in a bit later. Dr. Sangeeta Reddy, Joint Managing Director, Apollo Hospitals, Hyderabad. Dr. Sangeeta Reddy is a global healthcare leader, Indian entrepreneur and humanitarian, and the joint managing director of Apollo Hospitals Enterprise Limited, Asia's largest and most trusted healthcare group. Dr. Reddy is also the immediate past president of the Federation of Indian Chambers of Commerce and Industry, which is known as FICCI. We also have Professor K. Vishwanath, Lee Kum Kee Professor of Health Communication, Harvard University. Vishwanath Garu is also director of Harvard T.H. Chan School of Public Health, India Research Center. He also serves as chair of the Working Group on Vaccine Confidence, National Vaccine Advisory Committee, Government of the United States of America. He's going to give us a different perspective altogether. We have Dr. Mangayar Karasi, B, Additional Professor and Head of the Department Microbiology, AIIMS, Mangalgiri, Andhra Pradesh. Dr. Mangayar Karasi, V, is Additional Professor, Microbiology and Nodal Officer for COVID-19 at AIIMS Mangalgiri, Andhra Pradesh. She has an MBBS, an MD in Microbiology and a PhD in Microbiology/Pediatrics. Our last panelist, Dr. Sai Praveen Harana, Consultant, Intensivist and Pulmonologist at Apollo Hospitals, Hyderabad. Dr. Sai Praveen Harana is an MBBS, MPH, FCD, both certified in internal medicine, pulmonology, and critical care medicine. Simultaneously, he is member of board of regents at the American College of Chest Physicians. Dr. Harnath is also clinical director, Apollo LAM Clinic, which is part of the LAM or LAM Foundation International Clinic Network. So, Adandi, mana panelists yokka introduction. I think Sangeeta Reddy garu andarki suparichitarale. Let's begin with Dr. Sangeeta Reddy. Ma'am, if you're comfortable, a bit of Telugu would be nice. Whatever works, English, Telugu, and I'll probably try and translate. So, Dr. Sangeeta Reddy, shall I pose the first question to you, ma'am?
Of course.
Yeah, thank you. As the leader of the largest private hospital in India, Apollo Hospitals, how did your hospital prepare? I mean, what is the system you followed to respond to COVID-19?
So first, let me say thank you to Harvard for putting this program together. I think it's extremely critical that journalists should have an appropriate view of what's happening on the ground. And so I commend you for this initiative and also convey my regards to Mr. Reisman for, you know, for being here. Andarki namaskaram. Chala mukhyamaina vishayam entante that prati okkaru ee pandemic gurinchi enno maatladaru. There are so many views on what has happened. However, I think one of the most important things which have emerged is that ee pandemic tarvata andarki chala clear ga telusindi that the role of healthcare has to be played by governments, the hospitals, industry also, or the supply chain, by all educational and scientific institutions, and a very major role by the public and the individuals themselves. So prati oka crisis ilanti health crisis lo it's important for us to understand that everyone has a role to play. And this is very well highlighted during the pandemic, because the fact is that if public do not follow the right kind of precautionary methods, they don't wear a mask, they don't follow social distancing, then the number of cases rise. And with the rise in cases, the pressure on the healthcare system increases. With that pressure on the healthcare system increasing, what could normally, the lives which could normally be saved, sometimes we cannot save them because of this overload. So the first point I'd like to make is that this is a holistic system. Next point, Apollo Hospitals are cheap. Memo hospital beds, out of our 10,000 beds, today we have dedicated almost 4,500 beds for COVID care, of which over 1,500 of these are intensive care or critical care beds. Next to the beds, besides the beds, we are actually handling approximately 22,000 patients, because the combination of using technology platforms and telemedicine, the home care division, where we're treating almost 4,500 people in a remote care environment, the hotels that we have converted into stay isolated rooms using telemedicine, and we're monitoring their blood pressure, their sugars, their SpO2 using a remote care device and putting people. So hotel rooms have quickly been converted. In addition to that, we have set up over 27 isolation centers on the sites of corporates themselves, like NTPC or other PSU companies and other corporates. Besides this, we're doing a large number of video consults. So the approximate estimation is about 21 to 22,000 patients are being handled at any given time. This integrated effort, and the fact that I think it's very important for us to, kind of reach out. So on the app, on our YouTube channel, talking to our doctors giving lectures, our Facebook Live sessions, which we're conducting every day. We hope that the public information that we're able to give is a very important role in keeping people safe or telling them when to get the appropriate care. The other important angle is that we're also doing education. So we have conducted over 1.5 lakh training programs for healthcare workers on use of ventilator. Ila chala chala initiatives, different areas are chestunnamu. So hospital bed matrame kaadu, vere type chusukuntamu. Our hope is that we can quickly get over the pandemic, and towards that, our next important step is vaccination.
Okay. Chala mandi journalists, ma'am, ante memo on social media lo, we keep getting a lot of posts about the lack of beds, lack of ICU, ICU units, oxygen, vaccination. So does the Apollo Hospital Group have any suggestion to the other hospitals or to the government on how to deal with it? I also want to tell you that we roughly have about 2 to 3 minutes for each answer so that we can cover everybody.
Thank you. So basically, complex questions, detailed questions, adigi oka chinna answer is that it's not going to satisfy your people. But I think the combination of optimizing the number of beds, use all available beds, make knowledge and information about these beds available to public. Because public vachi oka hospital bed ledu, oka 3 hospitals itla tirigi, అందరూ ఫోన్ల మీద వాట్సాప్ ల మీద బెడ్ ఎక్కడ దొరుకుతుందని ఇలాంటి కష్టపడుతున్నారు. సో ఆప్టిమైజ్ ద బెడ్స్, కీప్ ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ అబౌట్ ద బెడ్స్ అండ్ ఎన్షోర్ ద సప్లై చైన్ ఆఫ్ ఆక్సిజన్, రెమ్డెసివియర్, క్రిటికల్ మెడిసిన్స్, పీపీఈస్ అస్ వెల్ అస్ ది అవైలబిలిటీ ఆఫ్ స్టాఫ్. ఫైనల్ గా ఈ ఆప్టిమైజింగ్ ఎఫిషియన్సీ, ఈరోజు ఇంటర్నేషనల్ నర్సెస్ డే, సో నేను ఒక హాఫ్ అ సెకండ్ లా మా nurses need, I want to acknowledge them. I want to thank nurses for the tremendous role that they are playing during this pandemic. And I want to request the media that please try to help the healthcare system in this difficult time. If we give sensational news and information, it only ignites the emotions and the passion rather than having a factual methodology. And therefore, the request is, please help us, because when people, kind of ignite their negative emotions and passions, it is not productive towards solving a problem. Scientifically, data-based, together, we should solve problems.
Yes, ma'am. Yes. So sensationalize cheyakandi, sensitive ga correct information ivvandi antunaru Dr. Sangeetha Reddy garu. Ma'am, could you tell us about Apollo Hospital's leadership on vaccinating people as rapidly as possible to minimize the spread of the disease, and what are the challenges you're facing currently in doing this?
So basically, vaccination is a very, very important step in helping the country overcome. And my database prakaram gunda, the government's first phase of giving healthcare workers vaccines, we had over 28,000 of our workers take the vaccine. By God's grace, less than 3% of them have had the second infection. And therefore, it's been a very successful vaccination program. Ippudu, as it's been opened up for people, number one, maku vaccine shortage is a significant problem. However, we have managed to get some supplies and we are giving as many as we can. So supply of vaccine outside la adho ka problem. Inko side la staff is also a problem. Endukante man daggar unde healthcare workers andaru patient care lane chala busy gunnaru. However, deen korakuda memo extra staff pettukoni general duty assistants ni vaccinators kinda oka training program ichi, online training ichi. మేము మా ఇన్ఫ్రాస్ట్రక్చర్ ని తయారు చేసుకున్నాం. మాకు 1.25 lakh డోసెస్ పర్ డే ఇచ్చే కేపబిలిటీ ఉంది, సప్లై చైన్, మ్యాన్ పవర్ ఎక్సెట్రా. ఇది వ్యాక్సిన్ కొంచెం ఇంకొంచెం చేతిలో రాగానే మేము స్టడీగా ర్యాంప్అప్ చేస్తూ ఉంటాం. ఇప్పుడు అప్రాక్సిమేట్లీ ఒక 7,000 to 10,000 వ్యాక్సిన్స్ పర్ డే ఇస్తున్నాము. సో ఇది ఒక 10-fold ఇంక్రీస్ అవుతుంది అన్నమాట.
ఓకే ఓకే మ్యామ్, that's nice. This is one thing from based on I'm also a journalist, as you know, I'm with the Union Express. Based on your experience of interacting with journalists, what suggestions do you have? I mean, you just told us not to sensationalize, but inka emanna pointers cheppagaltaru? Ippudu ee roju mana webinar lo chaala mandi journalists telugu and english vallu join ayyaru, so meeku elanti ibbandulu anipistundi? Maybe you could give us with a small anecdote of how some wrong reporting really had a tremendous impact. And
so mukhyanga nenem cheppalante, first I want to congratulate journalists, because ilanti bhayankaramaina pandemic time lo kuda journalists prathi sotala kanipicharu. They wore a mask, they went out into the field, so your pursuit of information and bringing information to the public is quite commendable. Inko mukhyamaina mata endante, ippudu information channels chaala perigipoyayi. Television, the internet, using the mobile phone, the print media, the combination of availability. And India has a very vibrant democracy and a very vibrant free press. The important point I would like to tell the media is that they will, as new science is developing, the vaccine gurinchi, please do not allow people to have unfounded fears. The doubts about is the vaccine correct, should I take it or not, ila chaala mandi they wasted the opportunity to take vaccines in the first place because of this fear. So that is a very important point, because the science and the process of validating the vaccine was very robust, and therefore we should encourage people to take the vaccine, because that is the only way for us to overcome this. Inkokati, this rumors about there is a variant, there is a double variant, this the old vaccine will not protect you from this double variant, ila this is an unfounded information or a hypothesis. So public ku chaala mukhyamga a message telpala, this is a hypothesis, this is a validated fact, this is a suggested go forward method. The difference between these three have to be clearly kind of conveyed to people, because it is important for us now to make people go ahead and take the vaccine. Yesterday you saw the chief scientist of WHO, Dr. Soumya Swaminathan, clearly said that the double variant or B1617 or 7 is a virus or a mutation of concern. But there is no proof that the current vaccines will not protect you against that mutation. And the vaccine platforms are fairly robust. they have managed to protect against many of the already the vaccine. The virus has mutated over 400 times in the current documentation. So why should we think that it will not help? And anyway, it is protecting against all the other mutations. So the biggest message is, please segregate between what is a hypothesis, what is a current knowledge or validated science, and what is a recommendation for public to go forward. Because ultimately, valaku simple ga recommendation iyala. A simple recommendation endante, meeru age group lo unte meeku vaccine dorukutunte kindly teeskondi. Adi simple ga cheppala. Vere anni double mutant teeskovalana ledha, covax a, covid shield a, should we wait for Sputnik? Ilanti hypothesis and propositions which are not in the interest of the individual or a public at large or the country may kindly be muted, because the journalist is an educated person. You have the ability to discern between different factors and put forward a recommendation. So ilanti pandemic situation lo mi mata chala vilubainadi. Kindly, meerana direct ga cheppandi, lekunte doctors dwara cheppiyan. Kani patient ku manchi salaha iyyan.
Sure. Right, ma'am. Noted all the suggestions. Sangeeta Reddy garu telugulo kuda chepparu, chala thanks andi. Ma'am, there are many questions coming up. Our panel will sort of pick out the best questions and we'll get back to you. Please, ikkada participants andaru kuda dayachesi meeru meekunna questions ikkada chat box lo veyandi. Ma team anta chustunnaru, definitely ga meeru adigina questions ki panelists dwara answers ippistamu. Now moving on to Dr. K. Vishwanath. Welcome, Dr. Vishwanath. I believe your time zone is different, but we are so happy to have an expert like you. Can we have Dr. Vishwanath on the spotlight, please? Thank you. Dr. Vishwanath, my question to you is, medical advice is being offered by unsolicited experts. Sometimes even meme pages in Instagram have been talking about their own things. What are some of the steps key stakeholders in India can take to curb misinformation, especially about the pandemic?
నమస్కారం. మీరందరూ ఈ వెబినార్లో వచ్చినందుకు ఎస్పెషలీ ప్యానలిస్ట్కి నా కృతజ్ఞతలు. నేను నా జవాబు ఇంగ్లీష్లో చెప్తాను, ఎందుకంటే నాకు ఐ వాంట్ బి వెరీ ప్రిసైజ్ ఇన్ ద లాంగ్వేజ్ ఐ యూస్, ఎస్పెషల్లీ అరౌండ్ ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ దో ఐ అండర్స్టాండ్ తెలుగు. సో లెట్ మీ జస్ట్ సే దాట్ సోషల్ మీడియా హ్యావ్ మేడ్ ఇట్ వెరీ కాంప్లికేటెడ్ ఇన్ టర్మ్స్ ఆఫ్ డిస్సెమినేటింగ్ ప్రిసైజ్ ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్. And we know from our research and research done by others that when communications is extremely critical and foundational to mitigating the crisis, especially in public health emergencies like this, and what it needs is transparency, complete transparency and credibility in what you are communicating. And that's the reason journalists play a very critical role. Because of the proliferation of platforms, people are confused and information is coming from every which way and every direction. And particularly with social media, especially with WhatsApp, anybody can get up on social media and forward a message. Everyone has become an information producer and a disseminator, right? And so we always call journalists as critical gatekeepers, because journalists have the ability, capability, and responsibility to really separate facts from fiction. But that gatekeeping is lacking in social media. So what do we do with it? I think there are a couple of suggestions I'll be happy to elaborate later when we have time. So one is institutions. So Dr. Sangeeta Reddy was actually referring to this, right? Institutions, whether it's hospitals, whether it's the government, or other institutions should become much more agile in the way they communicate information. I think it's extremely important because, they have the credibility. So for example, Apollo has the credibility, the state government has the credibility. And I think, their communication departments, should really think about, you know, how social media work and how to really communicate this information through social media, because that's one of the ways people are getting a lot of these rumors, I think, you know. And so that's one thing we should definitely think about. But also, I think, you know, the government, you know, I think one of the challenges with the government is that if you are perceived as not being transparent and that you're hiding information, then you lose your credibility pretty quickly, right? So the tendency of the governments, tendency of the authorities usually to step back and not release all the information for whatever reason. In fact, what we recommend and our experience with public health emergencies is you give out as much information as possible, as quickly as possible, as long as it is accurate, right? You can go out and say what you know about the crisis and what you do not know about the crisis and what is being done about it. That level of transparency actually builds trust, and that will increase compliance. Even, and so that so institutions have a big role to play in communicating this, you know, and making becoming very agile about it. The second is individuals. I think journalists, again, journalists should not chase every rumor. In my view, I think there are some authoritative sources out there, and I think they should rely on that. You know, I think you keep hearing double mutant, triple mutant, and as Dr. Sangeeta Reddy was saying, in a variety of these propositions, some of them unfounded, and you know, you can't chase every rumor out there and still cover responsibly, right? And also, there are a few authoritative publications out there. And you should be able to cover them. See, one of the things you have to learn is science is changing every day. Science is evolving, right? So for journalists, they have to realize what science has been validated in peer-reviewed publications, right? Not because somebody said it, because they have an MD in their name or something else. I can put an MD in after my name and put it on WhatsApp, right? But the issue is, has this been peer reviewed? Have authorities looked at the data very closely and then made the decisions? So it has to be data driven, you know, science driven. And I think that will actually, you know, stem this kind of a panic, you know, that's extended to the population. The last thing I want to say in the interest of time is individuals too have a responsibility, right? I often see today, you know, I already received, and this is just the beginning of my day, but I already received about 10 messages on WhatsApp about new you know, medication, new vaccines, etc. You know, my plea to the public is don't believe everything you see on WhatsApp. You know, you don't have to, what do you do? You know, even if there is a new vaccine discovered somewhere, you don't have anything to do with it. You have two vaccines that are available in the country. They're being given out as fast as they're available. Just focus on that. I think the thing with is, you know, when there is this crisis, people are uncertain. Uncertainty drives the need for information and making sense of the situation. That's why people are trying to rely on all kinds of information. Bamu, Samti, Jelakarra, Pasupu, you know, people are using whatever they want to use. None of that will work. We know that, right? We'll rely on doctors who are on the panel here, rely on the scientists on the panel. They know what to do. They have been following all these things. You know, what you should do as a public is follow the basic fundamental public health measures. Wear your face mask. Maintain physical distance as much as you can. Practice hygiene. Obey and comply with community mitigation measures like lockdowns and curfews. That will take care of you rather than chasing every WhatsApp message that is out there and even forwarding every message out there.
Right. Thank you so much, Dr. Vishwanath. So, Dr. Gar in Chapunarante, Madam Sadhananga, oka doctor, oka news ivagane, dani manam story ga rasis kuntuntamu. Kani Vishwanath Gar, Dr. Vishwanath Gar in Chapunarante, a particular news ni, ayane chepara, avide a doctor chepara, lekapothe, has it been peer reviewed? Ante inkoka doctor or inko medical authority, have they also given it the go ahead? I think that kind of a thing, manam. But that's a very valid point, sir. We shall definitely follow that. Now we move on to Dr. Harinath. Dr. Harinath, are you available here?
Yes. Hi. Namaste.
Yes. Hi. Thank you. Yes. So quick question to you is, I think you are comfortable in Telugu. Can I ask you in a Telugu?
In Telugu, meeku ardhamaithe chalandi.
Okay, okay. So, ippudu COVID-19 teekaku sambandhinchi, janallo inka kuda koncham sankocham kanapadutundi, like they call it vaccine hesitancy. I mean, it's been what, 5-6 months since the vaccine has come. So teeka teeskodan kosam swatahaga proactive ga vastunnarani bhavistunnara? మీరు ఎలాగా ఆ వాళ్ళ భయాల్ని ఎలా పోగొడుతున్నారు ఒక డాక్టర్ గా హూస్ ఇంటరాక్టింగ్ విత్ పేషెంట్స్ ఆన్ ఎన్ ఎవ్రీడే బేసిస్.
షూర్. ఇఫ్ యు టేక్ 2019 లోని WHO కేమ్ అవుట్ విత్ టాప్ 10 గ్లోబల్ హెల్త్ థ్రెట్స్. దాంట్లో వ్యాక్సిన్ హెసిటెన్సీ వాస్ వన్ ఆఫ్ దెమ్. దిస్ ఇస్ బిఫోర్ కోవిడ్. సో వ్యాక్సిన్ హెసిటెన్సీ ఇస్ నాట్ అ న్యూ ప్రాబ్లమ్ అండ్ నౌ వీ హావ్ సీన్ దట్ పీపుల్ విత్ మీజిల్స్ పోలియో దోస్ ఆర్ థ్రెట్స్ విచ్ ఆర్ ఎమర్జింగ్ అగైన్ బికాస్ పీపుల్ ఆర్ స్టాప్ టేకింగ్ దోస్ వ్యాక్సిన్స్. So vaccine hesitancy is a long standing human problem which has not been fully solved. Ippudu COVID crisis lo I would think most of the hesitancy is because of misinformation. We have to congratulate the world scientists for coming up at warp speed, literally at treating COVID and also coming up with the vaccines for it. Almost nobody wants to test something on a population which is unsafe. There is no gain for them to give something out which is unsafe. So there are many safeguards before something gets released to the public. And as doctors, we would never give something which we thought was unsafe. So what is being done right now? Ippudu vaccines to mana population ichetappudu clarity undi, effect undi, efficacy ante vaccine isthe infection vache risk tagutadi. My experience lo ippudu severe cases are extremely rare in people who have been vaccinated. Exceptions untai, but generally anybody who has been vaccinated vallaku severe effect undadu, infection ravachu. So you can get infected but you will not have a severe case. At the same time, it is important to also report vaccine related side effects. Ippudu oka mandu mana usual ga 10 million people, 100 million people, billion people ki iste, there is something called bell shaped curve antaru. ఒక్కొక్క మనిషికి ఆ రెస్పాన్స్ వేరే వేరేగా ఉండొచ్చు, బట్ మెజారిటీ పీపుల్ యాక్చువల్లీ రెస్పాండ్ ద సేమ్ వే, దే గెట్ బెటర్ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ వ్యాక్సిన్, దే ఆర్ ప్రొటెక్టెడ్. బట్ హ్యూమన్ బీయింగ్స్ ఆర్ డిజైన్డ్ ఇన్ సో మెనీ వేస్, కొన్ని మందికి ఆ మాలిక్యులర్ డిఫరెన్సెస్ వచ్చి కొంచెం సైడ్ ఎఫెక్ట్స్ రావచ్చు. యాజ్ అన్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్, దేర్ ఆర్ సమ్ సైడ్ ఎఫెక్ట్స్ ఎక్స్ట్రీమ్లీ రేర్ వేర్ ప్లేట్లెట్స్ తగ్గిపోయాయి కొన్ని మందికి, బట్ దట్ ఈస్ సో రేర్ దట్ ఇట్ డజంట్ మ్యాటర్, ఇట్ ఈస్ లెస్ రిస్కీ దెన్ క్రాసింగ్ ద స్ట్రీట్. ఇప్పుడు లాక్డౌన్ లో స్ట్రీట్ క్రాస్ చేస్తే ఎక్స్ట్రీమ్లీ సేఫ్ అనుకోండి, ట్రాఫిక్ లేకుండా, బట్ జనరలీ ఐఎమ్ సేయింగ్ ఇన్ ఇండియన్ పాపులేషన్ మనం స్ట్రీట్ క్రాస్ చేస్తే ఇదే సమ్ రిస్క్ ఇన్వాల్వ్డ్, బట్ యాక్చువల్లీ ద రిస్క్ ఆఫ్ గెటింగ్ అ సైడ్ ఎఫెక్ట్ ఆఫ్ వ్యాక్సిన్ ఇస్ యాజ్ రేర్ ఇస్ దట్. ఇఫ్ యూ లుక్ ఎట్ ద నంబర్ ఆఫ్ పీపుల్ హావ్ బీన్ వ్యాక్సినేటెడ్ ఇన్ ఇండియా, యూ నో వీ ఆర్ లుకింగ్ ఎట్ ద గ్లాస్ హాఫ్ ఎంప్టీ ఆల్ ద టైమ్. లెట్స్ నాట్ డూ దట్. యూ నో ఐఎమ్ నాట్ ట్రైంగ్ టు పబ్లిసైజ్ ఎనీ పాజిటివ్ న్యూస్, నథింగ్ ఆఫ్ దట్ సార్ట్, బట్ అన్లెస్ యూ టెల్ పీపుల్ దట్ 175 million పీపుల్ హ్యావ్ బీన్ వ్యాక్సినేటెడ్ ఇన్ ఇండియా, that is more than the population of so many parts of the world. Think of the logistics involved, think of the people who came forward to get the vaccine, who actually said this is going to help me. This has happened in India already, and every day, yesterday or today, 2.2 million people actually got vaccinated. Those are numbers unheard of in most parts of the world. Despite that, we have a large country, there are many people who need to get vaccinated. Absolutely, it's important for us to continue doing this. I was just looking up online. See, I don't know how many journalists are there, but there are extremely good resources on the net, India-based resources. But US chesukunte Dr. Anthony Fauci, CDC and Jeptar. India has a CDC actually. If you just Google it, NCDC, there's a National Information Center which is continuously collating the information. Assume some inaccuracy konjam undachemo, reporting delays valla, but still, it's a very good resource. There is an India-based clinical trial registry, CTRIR. They register all the trials in India which are going on. In fact, if you look at a clinicaltrials.gov, an international website, there are over several thousand trials going on COVID. So if you want an idea for a story for you for the next 1 year, just go to those websites, look up the investigators who are doing these research trials, go talk to them. You will get amazing stories, human interest stories. You will understand how these people are doing it. There is a lot of really good work going on in India and around the world, collaborative research going on. Chala chotullo India patients are getting medicines from outside and getting tested. So there is a lot of good work going on. Vaccine hesitancy, the simplest way to look at it is, if you don't get vaccinated, you're putting other people at risk. I have seen today some news items of very unfortunate pregnant women dying of COVID. It is very sad. There are people who could have given it to her who didn't get the vaccine or didn't take the vaccine. Let's not become the people responsible for transmitting COVID to somebody else. You may be infecting somebody's brother, husband, wife, child. That's a very irresponsible thing to do. Along with, of course, masking and wearing, you know, the mask is very important, hand washing. So as doctors, you know, we are somewhat limited by participation and assistance from the public. And I think journalists like you have an extremely good rapport with the public because people read your news. Another data point to think about is human attention spans are less than that of a goldfish. It used to be 12 seconds, it is now 8 seconds. So people are going to look at the headline that you write. They're not going to read the details. So be very cautious. Ippudu meeru headline em rastaro koncha careful ga rayandi. Let it be informative and attractive. Let it be honest and true. But there are many ways you can make it so that people actually look at this. So I'm fortunate I work in an institution like Apollo where we have so many verticals doing so much work for COVID that I'm aware of what is happening in the country all the time. In fact, we have a very authoritative 40th edition of the clinical protocols. 40th editions in the last 15 months. We've been updating it every 10 days with the latest information. So there are good things going on.
Okay, thank you. Thank you so much, doctor. So I'm cheppina prakaram 2.2 billion la mandi ippudaka vaccine for tika veinchukone uddeshi konni exceptions ne meeru highlight chesi rayakandi antaru adi ivvandi gaani don't sensationalize antaru. Tarvata doctor Harnath garu inkote em chepparante headline chaala mandi headline chadive ardham chestaru so put it before giving your headline antaru doctor. Now we move on to Dr. Mangayar Karasi. Sorry, ma'am. I hope you are... hello. Thank you, Dr. Hanna. Dr. Mangayar Karasi, are you there, ma'am?
Yes, please.
Yes. Ma'am, so there is this, especially social media, ante ee madhya manaku edi open chestha social media. Currently, the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare recommends that women are pregnant or are not sure of their pregnancy or are lactating, they should not receive COVID-19 vaccine. This sounds strange, but it's about that.
Yes. First of all, thank you for the opportunity. I thank the organizers. The Ministry of Health and Family Welfare and the Indian government have recommended that the pregnant and lactating women should avoid the COVID-19 vaccination. Pregnant and lactating women have not been a part of any COVID-19 vaccine clinical trial so far. The current available vaccines, we know the Covishield and Covaxin, the phase 1, 2, 3 have gone, and now they are going for the other phases, especially for pregnant women and the children. But and should not receive COVID-19 vaccine at this time. That's clearly the ministry said. Caution the health ministry in its note on precautions and contraindications for the vaccines. However, studies are underway. As per the WHO recommendation, pregnant and lactating women were not included in the initial clinical trials of COVID-19 vaccines. However, studies are underway. Available COVID-19 vaccines are not live virus vaccines. Available data from animal studies have not shown harmful effects in pregnancy. This is from WHO, CDC, and international. That's why they started giving the pregnant ladies and lactating women and even children. However, long-term safety data not yet available. Got it? Manju, got it?
Manju might have gotten disconnected.
Right.
While we wait, Professor Vish, should we just tackle some of the questions? I know we have limited time.
Yeah.
Questions in the chat box, we can start answering some of them until Manju gets back.
So, Dr. Sai, would you like to take the first one? I mean, the second one from Srinath of Sakshi TV. why is the fatality rate high in youth?
Sure.
And some media has reported that children will be affected in the third wave.
Sure. So Manju Garu, you're just picking some of the questions while you're coming back on.
You're back on, it looks like.
Yeah, she's back. Okay.
So I'll just tackle that question really quick. See, Pro, it's like raining right now, so it looks everybody's going to get wet. అందరికి ఒకేసారి ఇన్ఫెక్షన్ వచ్చింది విచ్ ఇస్ వై ఇట్ ఈస్ లుకింగ్ లైక్ ద రేట్స్ ఆర్ హైయర్ యూజువల్గా ఇఫ్ యూ కంపేర్ ది యాక్చువల్ ఏజ్ డిస్ట్రిబ్యూషన్ ఆఫ్ ది ఇన్ఫెక్షన్ ఇట్ ఈస్ యాక్చువల్లీ లుకింగ్ లైక్ ద రేట్స్ ఆర్ అబౌట్ ద సేమ్ యాజ్ ద లాస్ట్ వేవ్ అగైన్ దేర్ విల్ బి ఎక్సెప్షన్స్ బట్ ఇట్ లుక్స్ లైక్ ద రేట్స్ ఆర్ అబౌట్ ద సేమ్ వీ విల్ నో ద ఫుల్ ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ ఓన్లీ ఆఫ్టర్ ద వేవ్ ఇస్ ఓవర్ వెన్ యూ కెన్ టాలీ ఆల్ ద డేటా అండ్ పుట్ ఇట్ టుగెదర్ So from that standpoint, it looks like it is the same rate. However, there is some, you know, the doctors are discussing it. We don't have authoritative information. When we discuss it, it looks like some younger people are getting more infected, are inflamed more, but that may be also because of the very good immune system that people have. So if you have a very good immune system, you're going to fight it more. So adi koncha kanipistundi maaku, but it is not a universal thing at this point. So that's one part of it. In terms of children, I'm not a pediatrician, but from what I've heard, there is some talk that kids might get affected because they have not been vaccinated. You're going to have a variant which is not covered by the vaccine, which is present right now. But luckily for us, viruses mutate. All viruses mutate. In fact, there are trillions of viruses circulating Earth right now. These viruses mutate continuously. Some of the mutations are harmless. In fact, the virus dies down. And it disappears. And that is the prayer and hope we all have that this virus goes away that way. But some viruses will become more infectious. But we are now so adept at understanding the virus shape, structure, genetic markings, surveillance of the genome. I am confident that we'll pick up these much, much sooner as the days go on.
Okay. Thank you, Doctor.
And if I can add just one line for media. Yeah. I would request you to encourage the government to enhance the amount of genetic testing that is happening, the speed of sharing this genetic information, and to reactivate and unify. There is a network of all the genetic labs. It is important for these to talk to each other and to collate the information they're getting. And put this out either to other hospitals and scientists or in the public domain so we can plan our reactions and our treatment based on the data of the genetic presentation of the current mutations.
Okay. Okay, ma'am. Thank you so much. This question goes to Dr. Vish. Dr. Vish, are you around?
Yeah, I am here. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. So this journalist, I didn't get the name, but in the case of corona, there is more fear among the people than the disease. My opinion is that even deaths are caused by fear and anxiety. What steps should be taken to allay the fear among people so that they don't panic? What are the ways also?
Right. I think the in essence, you know, some of that has been addressed here, right? So most people, so there are 1 billion people in India. You have about, you know, a certain percentage getting COVID and another certain percentage recovering from it and a large number of people recovering from it. I think the fear stems from uncertainty, as I said before, because people don't know what to do. They keep hearing about it, you know. In fact, even in the West, we see nothing but pictures of crematoria and funeral pyres without, you know, which sort of desensitizes and creates a sense of helplessness amongst all of us. I think, you know, a lot of it can be addressed because fear, as we know from research, can be reduced and mitigated by just showing people what can be done to reduce fear. And those steps are fairly simple. You know, taking care of the minimum precautions, like, you know, as I keep repeating myself, you know, physical distancing or hygiene, you know, or personal hygiene, or wearing face masks. Those are within your hands. That you don't need a fancy hospital. You don't need to flood the hospitals and flood the messages to doctors and others. These steps can be taken by you within your hands. And this is something that is really important to communicate to people, that you cannot treat yourself out of this disease, right? The most important thing is to stop actually getting the disease, if not at least, to minimize this contamination and spread of the disease, which means, you can take very simple steps. Very simple steps, such as healthy living, taking care of yourself, taking those minimum precautions, doing mental health is important, doing the meditation, whatever you do. I think these are very simple things, right? Face mask, hygiene, physical distance, comply with the laws, take care of your physical health, take care of your mental health, and you'll be fine. Most people will be fine. Then you can leave it to people like Dr. Srina, Dr. Harnath and Dr. Sangeeta Reddy to take care of the people who are actually sick, and it will actually help the hospitals and the doctors if you follow those very simple, basic, elementary steps.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Dr. Vishwanath. This question goes to, am I not visible, but that's okay. We'll go with the next question. This is for Dr. Harnath. The question is very simple, doctor. How long should a person wait to take the vaccine after he or she recovered from corona?
Sure. See, the guideline is variable depending on who you ask, but medically speaking, after you're out of quarantine, you can take it. And because of the surge, I have been recommending people within 2 weeks after your test, you can actually take it. Don't take it if you're still having symptoms, fever, if you're unwell, don't take it. The general guidelines are for longer. If you took plasma, you can't take it for 3 months. And the antibody is also going to be available very soon for preventing COVID once you get it. If you take the antibody, even for those, you should not take it for 3 months. Otherwise, in general, the recommendations within 2 weeks is what I have been advocating. It's a little different than what some of the guidelines say.
Okay, thank you, doctor. This question is to Dr. Mangayar Karithi. I think we lost her shortly for a few minutes because of connectivity. Ma'am, are you there? Dr. Mangayar Karithi, are you there?
Yeah, you are muted.
Yes, I am muted.
Okay ma'am. Shall I repeat the question, ma'am?
Yes, please.
Okay. The question is, some people are getting infected with COVID-19 despite getting the first dose of the vaccine. This is raising questions about the effectiveness of the vaccine. So can you explain why this happens and how we should look at it?
Yes. To better understand this, we need to know the science behind how the human body reacts to viruses in general. When a virus enters into the human body, the natural immune system generates antibodies. So most of the people, the antibodies generated, natural immune system are not adequate after the first dose to fight against the virus. The vaccine steps into help the immune system. So when the first dose of the COVID-19 vaccine is given, it triggers the natural immune system to produce the primary immune response first, then later secondary response. So the two immune responses are there, primary and secondary. So the primary response will produce antibodies which will neutralize the viruses. We call it as a IgM antibody scientifically, medically. The secondary response system will produce specific antibodies called IgG. These two antibodies can be estimated also. The second dose strengthens the immune system, so the vaccine effectiveness is increased. So the second dose is needed to allow production of long-lived antibodies and development of memory T cells. So the memory cells are very, very, very important to protect from the virus. So this only trains the body to fight against the virus, building up the memory to protect the body when exposed to the virus in future also. So since this, after the second dose, it strengthens the immune system. After the first dose, it's not at all adequate. Some may get infected even after getting the first dose. In other words, the effectiveness of the vaccine is not adequate after the first dose. The effectiveness is also degraded by the body physiology over the time. Hence, it is important to have the second dose. The currently available
Please go ahead, Ms. Manjat. I think she's having trouble with
it. Yes. This question again goes to, I mean, any of you panelists or to Dr. Harnath or Dr. Vishwanath. For the last 2 days, there are contradictory news about ivermectin. I hope that's the right pronunciation. Ivermectin. While WHO says not to use it, one state government said that irrespective of getting infected or not, it can be taken. Have you heard of this or what's your take on this?
I think I've heard of this. One thing for sure, ivermectin is going to cause a parasite-free India. It works on parasites and, you know, most people are going to have parasites go. In terms of COVID though, the data is unclear. We have had discussions with doctors who are using it, doctors who advocate for it, and also health systems which advocate for it. As of now, it's relatively safe, but we don't know for sure. Never has anyone taken ivermectin at such a large scale. We hesitate to take vaccines, but we take ivermectin blindly. So in other words, we need to figure out, can we balance it? We need to surveillance to exactly see, is there a benefit from it? There are people who have said they've been helped by it, but without doing a proper study, you're only guessing. The studies that have been done have shown some element of a signal that it may work. But the experts I have spoken with have not said that it is 100% foolproof shot. But there are some who believe it does work. So I think if it's a short course and a short duration, especially if you're taking high dose steroids, it would be okay to take a dose to prevent super infection by a very particular parasite called Strongyloides. In that situation, ivermectin can be used.
Okay, thank you so much. ఇక్కడ ఉన్న విలేకరులందరికీ కూడా మన చాట్ బాక్స్ లో రిసోర్సెస్ అంటే ఎలాంటి వెబ్సైట్స్ ఎలాంటి యాప్స్ ఆర్ ఎలాంటి పర్సన్స్ ని మీరు కాంటాక్ట్ చేయొచ్చు మీ స్టోరీస్ చేయడానికి అది త్వరలోనే ఐ థింక్ ఆల్రెడీ షేర్ చేస్తాము. సో థాట్ ఆఫ్ దట్స్ అబౌట్ ఇట్. ఒక ఫీడ్బ్యాక్ ఫామ్ ఉందండి, అందరు కూడా దయచేసి దాన్ని ఫిల్ చేయండి, సో దట్ ఇట్ గివ్స్ అస్ అన్ ఐడియా ఆఫ్ యు నో హౌ థింగ్స్ ఆర్ గోయింగ్ అండ్ హౌ థింగ్స్ క్యాన్ బి బెటర్ హ్యాండిల్డ్. Thank you everybody. Anything else that anybody else want to quickly add? We are like almost 1 minute left. Anybody, very quickly, but just a minute.
Let me just say let me first thank on behalf of Harvard Chan and the panelists for participation. What I suggest, and I know Dr. Sangeeta Reddy want to say something, but let me thank all of you. It's very critical, I think, you know, to provide accurate information, which is a reason behind organizing these webinars. So we'll continue to do that. And we'll hopefully we can continue to count on all of you to be a part of this. And thank you, Ms. Manjula. Go ahead, Dr. Sangeeta
Reddy. I just had one thing that was in a follow-up to what Dr. Vishwanath said as well, is that somehow the global community and many people in India also are feeling that our systems have broken down, that things are in a complete chaos, and the projection to the global. I have relatives, aunts, everybody in America who are saying, how are you managing? So I just want to say that the healthcare system is very stressed, but it is holding up. The Indian healthcare system has not collapsed. And I also want to say that the fact that there are small nursing homes, distributed hospitals in the private sector, they are in a way the first line of defense so that the large hospitals are not completely overwhelmed. So I do holding up. Let us give credit to our doctors and our nurses, and please let the global community not fear India. We are actually doing a fairly commendable job, and also scientific indications are that the virus is beginning to slow. I hope this is right. While it is spread to the districts, we have a very difficult month ahead of us, but our hope is that the worst is over.
Well said.
Thank you, Dr. Sangeeta. So I think we've almost run out of time. It's 7:30 and it's peak time for all the journalists. ఇక్కడ ఉన్న పత్రికా విలేకరులందరికీ కూడా చాలా ధన్యవాదాలండి. మీరు కొన్ని క్వశ్చన్స్ అడిగారు, దాన్ని ప్రస్తుతం మేము సమయాభావం వల్ల అడగలేకపోతున్నాం, కానీ దానికి సంబంధించిన రిసోర్సెస్ అన్ని కూడా వి విల్ బి సెండింగ్ ఇట్ టు యువర్ ఈమెయిల్ ఆర్ వాట్సాప్ ఆర్ వాట్ ఎవర్ వే ఆఫ్ కమ్యూనికేటింగ్. ఇక్కడైనా ఫీడ్బ్యాక్ ఫామ్ తప్పకుండా ఫిల్ చేయండి, బికాస్ ఇట్ హెల్ప్స్ us in improving. Thank you so much, everybody, Dr. Sangeeta, Dr. Vishwanath, Dr. Mangyara Kesi.
Thank you for organizing such a good and very important session. Our congratulations to you for this thought.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Bye-bye. Thanks for your time. Bye. Bye-bye.